So in this video we're going to continue to develop our character. In this video I'm going to show you how to continue to shape our model as well as start in the development of the face, getting the eyes ready, and also getting the initial shape for the boots and the gloves. So first we're going to do a little shaping here just so that we can develop the look. Let me go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool, get one there, I'll press Q and I'm going to select that edge loop and scale that a bit, just so that it looks a little more round. Now I want to start to develop the boots, so I'm going to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool. We're going to set that edge loop and scale it up just so that we can get the boots going here. This is just going to be the initial state because the boots require a bit more than just this, unless you want to keep it really basic. So this is what I call the initial stage for the boot. And we'll do the same thing for the gloves. I'm going to insert an edge loop here. I'll scale this one up. And probably this one as well. Let me go to normals, set normal angle, set it to something really high, doesn't matter, it can be any of the higher levels, just so that it doesn't look, it has a more smooth look to it. I'll press 3 and work on subdivision mode. Let me go to mesh, sculpt geometry tool options box, and I'm going to set it to relax. And I'll change the radius with holding down B and your mouse button. And what it does is it relaxes the area here just so that the edges are not too close to each other. And if you hold down Shift, it smooths the area. It can help whenever you have something that looks too lumpy. I like to use this tool. It takes less time than just grabbing an edge at a time. Alright, and just press Q to exit. I'm going to select almost the whole face and I'll bring the face forward a bit. I'll move that forward. I noticed that's almost how his face is in the concept. His neck seems to be really elongated. His neck is really long, so I want to make sure I get that. I'm using soft selection. I noticed that I have a gap here for my mesh in the middle. So I'm going to go up here and type 0 on the X, press enter. Just to so that it snaps, let me make sure that reflection is enabled. It seems it is. So if that happens, you can just go ahead and do that. Okay. So now let's go ahead and get started with the face. Let me insert an edge loop, one here and one right here. I want to have, let's see, I want to have five faces, so I'm going to insert another one. I want to have five faces from here to here. I want to have five faces, and your landmark will be these edges here. So you want to make sure to have five faces in between those two. And from the other side, I want to have four faces. Okay. I believe I'll probably use these two faces to extrude the eyes. So let me go to Edit Mesh, Extrude. I'll use my blue handle and move that in. I'm going to press G to extrude one more time. Press G. I'm going to press on the square to scale that in a bit and bring that out. I'm going to press G one more time, scale that in. And G one last time, bring that in. And I'm going to delete those faces. Alright, so now that we have the start for the eyeballs here, and now what we have to do is start to shape so that it looks like it's actually the area for the eyes. Let me go to Edit Mesh. I'm going to insert an edge loop. I'm going to get one here, maybe another one here as well, and one here, just so I have more to work with in terms of shaping the area here for the eyelids. So another thing that can help you is if we actually have the eyeballs there, just so that we can shape the eyelids around the eyeball. Right now it looks really alien-ish. So let's go ahead and create polygon primitives and let's create a sphere. Let me click here just to reduce the actual geometry. Alright, I'm going to rotate it and scale that in. I'll rotate that 90 degrees on the x-axis, and that's all I'm going to do, and just scale that in.